second installment. I'ma call it 10 minutes with Butter. So today I have a few things on my mind. This lady in front of me dumb as hell. So today's topic will be about nurturing, encouraging our young people, and also not holding things back from kids. I feel like it's a big, big, big mistake to keep shit away from kids. Like, it's very important not to hide stuff, because when these kids become adults, they be lost. Lost. Like, I'm really very, very transparent with my children that I want them to learn how to do things on their own. And that's mostly because it's a lot of people who don't prepare their children, and then, like, shit like cancer come up, or they get hit by a car or murdered. Like, the world we live in, you just gotta think like that. And people do not prepare their kids to fend for themselves. Teach them how to go get an ID. Teach them how to drive. Teach them how to wash their ass properly. Teach them how to apply for stuff. Take them with you. When my son was going to his first interview, we sat down and I did a mock interview with him. And I told him, as an interviewer, what I wouldn't accept from somebody I was interviewing. My son went that next day and got that job right on the spot. Right on the spot. And I feel like I prepared him for that. Now my son works full time. He a hard working young man. Get his little coins and take his ass home to his woman. A lot of people don't have that stuck in them from the beginning. All they know how to do is put their hand out and ask for shit. And kids need to know more than that. Stop padding everything for these kids, and then they don't know how to do shit. And they don't know how to they don't know how to write checks. They don't know how to open a bank account. They don't know how to do anything. I'd rather walk my kids through it so they'll know, and they can refer back to what mama said. You just don't know when you're gonna be taken away. And preparing them also, this really gonna get me. Prepare kids for people to tell them no. Prepare them. Because if you a yes person and you tell them you yes all the time, they're going to get pissed off when they get their first no. And they need to be prepared to hear no. No, you can't have that. No, I ain't helping you, Chad. No, you can't borrow. No, 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 no. Start saying no. Shit. Whenever I hear somebody say, my kids get whatever, or if I can afford it, they can have it. No, make them work for it. Because ain't nobody in this damn world giving their ass shit. Trust or believe. I'm just getting off work, so I'm tired, so. But while I'm in the car, I'm going to talk to y'all, because when I get home, I'm going to bed. Also, teach your kids about, like, as a child, I saw my mother go through a lot, a whole lot. Like, stuff that she probably hid from us for a while, because she didn't want us, to go through stuff. I'm talking about, like, abuse, all types of abuse. I'm talking about sexual abuse, physical abuse, mental abuse, financial abuse. Please stop telling your daughters to go find somebody who got money. Because they will hold that girl hostage just with that notion that she need them to support her. And your sons, they shouldn't be relying on no female to take care of them. So, show by example. Let's prepare our children, because this president here, Mr. Trump, because I ain't calling him president nothing. Mr. Trump gonna have us in a whole lot of trouble, and with his ass croak and leave his partner Pence in the seat, we gonna be jacked up. I'm not wishing no death on him, but you know, the Simpsons said that he gonna croak. So I'm gonna go with that. They've been right so far. Also, be very cautious about having your kids call people auntie, uncle, godmama, and all that shit. Especially if they're not living up to the expectation of a godmother and godfather and all that. Because a godmother and godfather is supposed to be the backup parent when something happens to you in life. Like if you expire or you something happens to you, they supposed to be stepping in and assisting with the upbringing of your child. These step parents out here raping y'all kids while y'all talk about they good people. If you know they a fucking freak beforehand, don't think they just stop because you they friend and that's their godchild. They putting hands on them. My kids got mothers. God bless them. They had kids of their own already, so it was kind of easy just to put them in a position to look out for my children. And they still do look out for my children from a distance because my son is grown. My daughter is of age herself, but they still look out for her. Just watch these people around your kids. I'm getting tired of hearing about stuff. Like, it's getting out of hand. I'm rolling through East Cleveland, so y'all gonna keep seeing me stop and look around. There's an ambulance and happy piece of nasty. They probably got salmonella from that nasty shit. Yes, I said shit. Alright, y'all. I ain't gonna take up no more of y'all time. I'm not even gonna do 10 minutes because last time it wouldn't even load to IG. I had to upload it to my YouTube page. So let's see what happens with this video. See if it upload to IGTV. I love y'all. Take care of yourself. And be good to yourself. You only got one you. Okay? Peace out.